The Big Island of Hawaii is well known for being one of the world's most volcanically active regions, as best displayed by the sheer number of young-looking lava flows which cover significant chunks of the island. Thus, when people think of volcanoes on the Big Island, they tend to think of the four volcanoes which are considered to be active or potentially active, which, listed in order of the least to most frequent Holocene volcanic eruptions, are Mauna Kea, Hualalai, Mauna Loa, and Kilauea. However, there is an often forgotten fifth volcano which forms a section of the Big Island. Known as the Kohala Volcano, this volcano encompasses the northwest section of the island and is largely ignored because it is extinct. However, as shown by still visible albeit eroded cinder cones, this volcano last erupted surprisingly recently in geologic timescales, as its last verified eruption occurred 60,000 years ago. This video will discuss the Kohala Volcano, whose edifice is considered to have the lowest risk of fresh lava inundation on the entire Big Island. Of the six volcanoes which were once above sea level, and either currently or at one point composed the Big Island of Hawaii, the Kohala Volcano is the second oldest. Kohala began forming around 950,000 years ago when at the time a small island existed due to the Mahukona volcano to the south, which was a mere 350 feet above sea level. Kohala's initial activity involved submarine volcanic eruptions on the ocean floor at approximately a depth of 2,500 feet. Although initially involving a southeast-trending fissure, volcanism eventually developed into a submarine shield volcano. Reaching the surface and beginning island building around 650,000 years ago, a brief explosive phase occurred due to the interaction of magma with shallow ocean water. Volcanism quickly thereafter shifted back to effusive and moderately explosive activity, building two distinct rift zones on the volcano. One rift zone went towards the southeast, while another went towards the northwest. These rift zones were the source of numerous flank eruptions which built an island which at one point was 35 miles long and 23 miles wide. Flank eruptions look very much like those witnessed at Mauna Loa in more modern times, creating fissure vents and cinder cones. However, occasional eruptions also occurred away from the summit and rift zones, even forming a secondary shield volcano. After several large volume flank eruptions occurred, likely towards the northeast, a summit caldera formed. Over time, lavas became slightly more silica-rich, allowing for occasional silica-rich basaltic composition lava domes to develop. By 300,000 years ago, the east-northeast slope of the volcano became overloaded, causing it to slowly slide towards the ocean at a rate of a few inches a year. Eventually, 275,000 years ago, this strain became too great and a large swath of that slope dramatically collapsed into the ocean in a massive landslide. This collapse not only left a U-shaped hole in the island, but also carved very deep valleys which remain in the landscape today, at least one of which is more than 3,000 feet in height from its top to the modern valley floor. This massive release of material from the island caused Kohala's long-term subsidence to temporarily cease and instead turn into short-term uplift. This caused a rejuvenated stage of volcanism to occur with more viscous and silica-rich lavas, which in a few tens of thousands of years completely filled in the existing caldera. These eruptions built more numerous lava domes than the prior shield-building stage, but over time became less and less frequent until its last eruption occurred 60,000 years ago. This marked the point at which the Kohala volcano became extinct. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank Kurz Sadowski for becoming a new channel member on YouTube of Geology Hub.